A good night's sleep is important, but what role does your mattress play in it? That's what we're going to talk about on this episode of SpineCast with Dr. Sean Riley from Tulsa Spine and Rehab. Welcome aboard, Dr. Riley.
Hey, Charlie, how are you?
I'm doing well. I got a good night's sleep last night because I have the advantage of having your mattress advice up front. So let me ask you, what role does the mattress play in getting a good night's sleep?
Sure. I've been in practice 18 years, and I will tell you that that's probably one of the most common questions that I get. You know, what type of mattress should I be using? And it's tough because, you know, mattresses can be very expensive. Everyone's resources may vary and so forth. So, you know, throughout the years, I've tried to, you know, I'm very mindful and careful of the recommendations that I make. So, I try to dumb this down as much as I can with my patients and explain that the mattress should be comfortable. Okay, obviously. You know, we're very tired when we get in bed at night. We want to go to sleep. We want to get some rest. It needs to be firm. And, you know, obviously secondary to comfort, I talk to patients about having a firm mattress because what we want the firm mattress to do is to provide a fair amount of support for us, our neck and our backs and so forth. So what happens a lot of times as a bed breaks down and you start to, you know, develop those cratering type of situations, you know, excessive stress and strain can be put on the joints of your neck and low back. For instance, a lot of my patients ask me, well, what are your thoughts on pillow tops? And, you know, I just want to quickly move on because I cannot stand pillow top mattresses. The issue that we have with pillow top mattresses is that in the showroom, man, these things feel really good. You know, they're very comfortable. Your spouse jumps on it and, you know, we could do this. The problem is months into having that pillow top, it starts to break down and crater. And so once again, you lose support. You lose that bracing, and so you develop increased pain and pressure irritation on joints. So, you know, related to a specific brand, Charlie, I'm very careful. You know, I, from personal experience, I have a Tempur-Pedic mattress. Those mattresses can be a little expensive. However, as technology has been around for a while, it's much more palatable. I mean, these mattresses are, you know, coming down in price significantly. What I like about the Tempur-Pedic is that, first off, from a longevity standpoint, I think we're 7 years into our mattress. Typically 7 years, 7 to 10 years is when you need to start looking for, that's the shelf life typically of a mattress. 7 years into this, it hasn't changed in that, you know, you take the sheet off and there's none of that cratering effect. And the other thing, obviously, that I really appreciate about the Tempur-Pedic, it's very, very firm and it provides a fair amount of support. So, you know, I think it keeps us relatively neutral when we sleep. You know, and I think a great indication of your mattress, if you're considering making some changes, how do you feel first thing in the morning? You know, a lot of patients will come in with, you know, complaining of low back pain and with no specific cause or injury or onset. And I'll say, well, have you noticed, is it time specific? Is it worse in the mornings? Does it progressively get worse throughout the day? And then if a patient tells me, you know, I feel really bad first thing in the morning, that in itself is an indication that you might want to look into a new mattress.
You say this Tempur-Pedic mattress is your favorite, but they also have a reputation for being like a big bag of sand when you're sleeping on it because they can be kind of warm.
Yeah, that's a great comment. So that was one of our biggest concerns is that, you know, we did a fair amount of research before we purchased that mattress. And so what happens is they have technology now where there's like it's some type of mattress cover that goes over it. I mean, it's relatively inexpensive, but what it does is it actually cools and I think essentially provides some airflow in there. So I am very mindful of temperature when I'm sleeping and I have not had any issue with that. Mm-hmm. The other, you know, caveat to that as well, on another note, it's going to take you some time to kind of get used to this, just like with most things, because I think a lot of us, you know, are just wired on the, you know, previous beds. They're too soft. They don't provide enough support. The Tempur-Pedic, I will say, probably took me, my wife, I don't know, 2 to 3 good months to kind of get used to it.
Sure.
And that, you know, it's a different type of surface. Mm-hmm. It's relatively firm. So I would give it some time if you move that direction.
It's like moving to a waterbed. I mean, that's a whole different experience than that. I assume that those are not on your hit list of the right thing to sleep on, by the way.
1978, Tulsa, Oklahoma. I had one, had the big wooden headboard, the whole bed. I look back on those days, Charlie, and I, for the life of me, I cannot imagine the genesis of those things, of how those things ever came to fruition. But I would definitely stay away from a waterbed.
Here's a more updated version of it. What about those air beds that they have where, you know, you can dial firmer or softer on one side or another? Where do you stand on those for a good night's sleep?
You know, Sleep Number, and like I said, I try to stay away from specific brands, but it's a good product. Those things can get pretty expensive, but yet I've had patients that have gone to the Sleep Number, and essentially what you can do is control, it gives you some flexibility. You can control the firmness, obviously, and make it a little bit softer. A lot of my patients, the spouses like those because, you know, one likes maybe a setting of 8 and the other may like a setting of 6. And so you're able to, you know, you have some flexibility in the amount of firmness on either side of the bed.
So there is a certain amount of personal preference that comes into this because you said a firm mattress, and I've seen these ads and articles that show like where like your shoulder is stressing against a firmer mattress. And they say, well, here's one that has like, I think it's called Purple, that's out there right now. That's almost like an egg crate kind of construction in it where you sleep on it and it molds itself to you. You're saying that's not the way to go.
Not a big fan. Once again, like if you feel yourself sink into the bed, ideally, you know, it might be you feel like it's a good thing.
It looks good in the movies.
Sure, absolutely. But over time, I think, you know, there's increased irritation and stress put on certain joints. Right. I think a golden rule, Charlie, should be we should be relatively comfortable, obviously, when we're sleeping. I'm not suggesting that, you know, we need to go to an uber firm type of a setup where you're not resting at night. I'm simply suggesting that, you know, a firmer mattress provides a fair amount of support and keeps us in a more neutral type position.
So to sum up, you're saying firm mattress, the way to know you got the right one is how do you feel in the morning, and stay away from water beds.
Yeah, absolutely. So firm is always going to be better. Okay. You know, and the way you feel first thing in the morning is a good indication, obviously, of how you feel. The last thing that I would mention specific to the mattress is that it's one of those things we probably don't want to look to save a ton of money on. And now I'm not suggesting that, you know, we need, like I said, everyone's resources may vary.
You don't want to pull your kids out of college for this.
Exactly. But yet you don't want to buy an $800 mattress like that's on clearance somewhere. And I'm weary of buying things like that online when we're not able to kind of give it a test run. A lot of these mattresses, too, that are a little bit more expensive, higher quality, they offer a very good like 90-day, you know, no obligation type return. So that's something else that I would look for while purchasing a mattress.
Some good advice, and you can find even more advice and lots more information and lots more of these podcasts at TulsaSpineAndRehab.com. Look for them under the news section. Dr. Riley, thanks again for your time today.
Thank you, Charlie.